This is a rate time distance problem, but it's a problem when only the distance is actually known. So in other words, we don't know exactly what the rate or the time is. So this problem can be done with two variables, but I'm going to do it using one variable, and we'll be working with a rational equation and a quadratic equation. So you will have already needed to know how to solve those kinds of equations. Here's the problem. Kira drove 200 miles from San Diego to Santa Barbara. On the return trip, she decreased her speed by 10 miles per hour, and the trip took an extra hour. What was her speed on the way back? First of all, it should make sense to you. If you're going slower, it's going to take you longer. So here's the problem again, and I have a little picture here. Say she starts at San Diego and she drives to Santa Barbara, and we know it's 200 miles. And then she goes back from Santa Barbara to San Diego, and you can see by the picture that the distances are the same. So I'm going to make a little chart to keep our information in. And we're going there and then we're returning. I'm just going to use that. You could write San Diego to Santa Barbara or something like that. Now, usually in rate times distance problem, we put rate time distance. I'm going to do it a little bit differently. First of all, we know the formula, rate times time equals distance, hopefully. Okay? And instead of putting the rate, the time, and then the distance, I'm going to put the distance first. And then I'm going to put the rate. And then I'm going to put the time. Now, we know that distance times rate does not equal time. What does time equal? Time is the distance divided by the rate. In other words, the distance divided by the rate equals the time. And you can get that from this little formula here by dividing both sides by r. Okay, so that's how you can see that the time is equal to the distance times the rate. All right, so if I make the put the distance in here, both of them are 200. I know what the distance is. Now, what about the rates? Going, I know there was some particular rate, but I don't know what it was exactly. Let's call that x. There was some rate. So going, let's say she went x miles per hour. On the return trip, what happened? She decreased her speed by 10 miles an hour. So if she was going X miles per hour towards Santa Barbara, on the way back, she decreased it by 10. That'll be X minus 10. So her time going is distance over rate, 200 divided by X. And on the return trip, the distance over the rate would be 200 over x minus 10. So that's where we're going to start. Now, what else did it tell us? It told us that on the return trip, it took her an extra hour. So I want you to look at this for a minute. Which took more time? Which one of these numbers is bigger? The time going or the time returning? Remember, she was going faster on the way there. Okay, so going, she was going faster, right? The miles per hour were more. And it was a slower trip on the return trip. So just think about which of these numbers is bigger. And hopefully you've got that the return trip, that much time, that's a longer amount of time. So just keep in mind that this is bigger. And it's bigger by 1 hour, right? So it's 1 hour longer than this trip over here. A lot of people get this confused, but just imagine if these two numbers, if there were two numbers here and this number was bigger, you would have to add one to this top number to make it equal the bottom number, all right? So in other words, if this was 9 and 10, right, 1 hour longer, you'd have to add 9 plus 1 to get 10. That's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to take the time going, which is a smaller number, 200 over x, and if we add an hour to it, we're going to get how much time it took her on the return trip. A lot of people do this exactly backwards. They add 1 to this bottom number, which is already a bigger number, so it won't make any sense. So this is our equation. So just keep in mind what this stands for is the time going, right? And this is the time returning. And the time returning was a bigger number. So you take the time going, add an hour, you get the time returning. And this is the equation that we're going to have to solve. So that's the next step. We're going to now solve that equation. So here's our equation, and it's a rational equation. So one way to solve a rational equation is multiplying both sides of the equation by the least common denominator to clear through the fractions. So looking at the denominators, we've got an x, we have an x minus 10, so the least common denominator is x times x minus 10. All right, so let's multiply each term on both sides of the equation by x times x minus 10. So I'm multiplying the first term, 200 over x times x minus 10. The second term is just 1, so that's just 1 times x minus 10. And on the right side, we have 200 over x minus 10, and I'm multiplying by x times x minus 10. Now, this will give us a problem without fractions because the x's cancel here. In this term, there are no fractions, so there's nothing to cancel, and the x minus 10's cancel there. So we have 200 times x minus 10. Let's just clean that up a little. 200 times x minus 10. And this is the same as just x times x minus 10. And on the right, we have 200x. All right, so let's do our distributive property. On the left-hand side, we have 200x minus 2,000 plus x squared minus 10x equals 200x. Now at this point, notice we have a quadratic because we have an x squared term. So that means we're going to set the equation equal to 0, and we'll use factoring. So I'm going to subtract 200x from both sides. So I could subtract 200x from both sides. Well, I can see that's going to wipe out that 200x. And then on the left, these three terms that are left, I'm going to write in descending order. So I'll have x squared minus 10x minus 2,000 equals 0. Okay, now we have to factor that. Or if you know the quadratic formula, you can also use that. Or if you know how to complete the square, you can do that. This does factor, and it probably will take you a little while to figure out the correct factors, but it can be done. You could just list all the possibilities, and eventually, hopefully, you'll get x minus 50 times x plus 40. Notice the middle term is a negative 50x plus 40x, so there's your negative 10x, and the last term will give you the negative 2,000. So that's the correct factorization. If you need help with factoring, look at my videos on factoring. Now we need to set each factor equal to 0. So x minus 50 equals 0, or x plus 40 equals 0. So either x equals 50 or x equals negative 40. Now if you recall, x referred to a speed. So you know what? This one doesn't make any sense. Speed cannot be negative. So x equals 50, this looks like it might work. So now let's go back up to what x stood for. X stood for the rate going, and then the return trip, x minus 10, stands for the rate returning. So going, if x was 50, then the return trip would be 40. So we'd have 50 miles per hour and 40 miles per hour. And ask for the speed on the way back. So it looks like it's going to be 40 miles per hour. But let's go ahead and actually check that. All right, so we got that x equals 50. So let's plug those numbers in. That means that this rate would be 50. And therefore, the return, 10 miles per hour less, would be 40. Okay, well, what would the time be? We know that rate times time equals distance, right? So 50 times what would equal 200? That time would be 4. And of course, you can get that by doing 200 divided by 50. And 40 times what would equal 200? That would be 5. Okay, so what happened? When you decreased their speed by 10 miles an hour, did it take an hour longer? Well, look at the time. Yes, it did take an hour longer. Now all we have to do is answer the question, what was their speed on the way back? Speed returning was, there it is, 40 miles per hour. Make sure you answer the question they ask you at the end.